Hello, everybody. When last we left off, I was flattening the top of the forearm on this English Walnut carving. And I'm going to finish that and proceed with doing the inletting. And we'll see how far we get in 20 or 30 minutes. I'm wearing I've got a lavalier microphone wrapped in a paper towel, stuck inside of my respirator, hooked up to my iPhone with an app with the gain turned all the way down. And so it's probably not going to be a great recording quality, but I think you'll be able to hear me if I have anything interesting to say on carving. Well, I don't know that it's often interesting. I always have all kind of thoughts going through my head while I'm working wood. Here we go. Like you would normally use to tighten the collet on a router, but then afterwards it gives you an Allen wrench locking capability. And the advantage with that is when you tighten up a regular collet nut, it moves the bit, you know, it pulls it up in there. And I like to set a very exact distance, which that would make difficult. They also sell them for spindle motors, which I have on the new machine over there. Boom. Yep, there's some water-cooled horsepower there. Can't wait to give that a try. It'll be quieter than the router. But I gotta say, I have loved this Milwaukee router. The big 3.5 horsepower. 7.6, I forget the number. But it's the common, the big one. Easy to change the bearings on it, which I've done once. All right, focus here. So the next cut is going to be the round cut. set the distance with narrow pins. Perfect. I leave a little extra wood on the outside, so there's going to be further carving and sanding and loss of wood, but on the inside, cut once, it's done. Let's hope. Sometimes got to clean it up on the milling machine. Alright, I would like, normally I'd like to have air for this part, but I don't have the air set up yet in the new cup, so I'll put a little acid brush to get down in there. Alrighty. So I'll check here. Things are tight, secure. There's zero clearance. Double checking. Yeah, that's tight. All right, here we go. see if the half inch fits in there. Dropping into the trigger guard opening, the cocking arm slot. You see, it's got an extra feature here. And then, get an acid brush. Who knows, this might be better than air. Brush is certainly quieter. So we're going to drop into there. This feature, we'll put down into there. And then we're going to cut this and that step. And then this through hole will probably jump up the next size bit. All right. Here we go. Thank you. it now or do it later. So, I'll poke the hole here for the master screw. And these two little divots. What are we doing on time here on the plank? 25 minutes. Talking about is the back of the action on these drywall stocks. I don't know how they did it, but they cut that half round right up to the back edge. Well, I can't do that. I got to use a round bit, so it's got a radius here in the back corner. It's got to be squared off. If I square it off with a quarter inch bit on the master, I can copy it. But instead, I'm going to have to square this up in the milling machine. Not a big deal. It's always bummed when I put it here. Alrighty. So, I'm not going to do anything about that. I'm just going to poke this main bolt hole and these two divots, and that's all I've got. I'm going to check that I'm perpendicular. I'm not going to. Chunk of extra wood there. A big chunk. Just want to give it some initial shape. Extra wood here on this cut doesn't matter a whole lot, but we got a lot to remove there.
Yeah.
Oops. Roll it sideways and start putting some shape into this block of wood. Yes, sir. That is fantastic. Now, we're moving up to around it. And we're going to start out leaving a ton of extra wood. You're going to see there'll be places where we don't have wood to carve. Good job right here. But I just like working up to it. Alrighty. I don't know why I was just giving that all a shake when I'm about to let her loose. Oh, that is so absolutely perfect. Did you see that? This bar went on perfectly. All right, we're going to loosen the clutches. And naturally, that tool got used somewhere else. But there's out of the brush. Well, let's start on this side. Gosh, what a beautiful piece of wood. Man, I can't wait to cut that side. Well, gotta have something to look forward to, I guess. I'll start on the presentation side first. I add a little friction to the clutch here. And I don't want it too tight. It has to go a little bit. Yep, that's good. Move it over here. That's pretty tight. All right, nice and snug. Here we go, let's make some tips fly. Oh, you gotta get your view turned up. Here we go, where are we at? 36 minutes. Okay, just a couple minutes of this and we'll call it quits. Well, not me, but you. Thank you. gonna be fantastic. All right. That's enough for this one. Michael out.